Life without an iPhone can leave some feeling disconnected. So when Jake Maudlin cracked his screen, he needed a fast solution.
I called Michael Weston, owner-operator of Kansas City iPhone Doctor, to get a screen replacement.
He'd used him before to fix his phone. Maudlin says Weston has most all positive reviews, and his website says he's Apple certified.
He had my screen fixed probably 15, 20 minutes. And the next day, I kind of noticed things weren't right.
He says the refurbished screen wasn't registering his touch, and it didn't seem to fit the phone right. So he took it to the Apple store.
They looked at it and told me it was an aftermarket screen. Took one look, and then they investigated further. And they said, yes, this is definitely third-party aftermarket.
Maudlin says the text told him Weston wasn't an Apple service provider. His business is not listed through Apple's search tool. Frankie Bellucci with Frankie on Call says aftermarket screens aren't Apple products. He also says it's always important to have the work in writing.
It's critical that that be a piece, especially when it comes to your phone. I mean, that's phone, computer, any sort of server, security equipment. I've got to know that I'm doing business with a professional.
Maudlin says he never got a work order for his screen from Kansas City iPhone Doctor. I reached out to Weston to get his side. I called, messaged, and even went to the business address listed on his Facebook and Yelp. It was a Phillips 66 gas station in KCK. We did not hear back from him before our deadline, and we will let you know if we do get a response. Bellucci says that can also be a red flag.
If you've done your due diligence and you've done your looked at your research, looked at, you know, the top three local guys and chosen one, you've now made the choice. So some of the responsibility is on you.
Be very careful. I would definitely contact Apple Care and go that route. Find an authorized provider from the Apple Care specialist versus Googling it like I did and then going to a website. I'd actually speak with Apple directly.
Sheree Honeycutt, Fox 4 News.